SchoolFreeware's QBasic tutorial series, tutorial 3, print formatting. Within this tutorial, we'll use separators. There are two basic separators. One is a comma, which places the output in columns. The other is a semicolon, which keeps the output next to each other. The code for tutorial 3 can be downloaded for free at schoolfreeware.com, and this tutorial uses QB64 running on Windows 7. First thing I'll do is clear the screen. Then I'll print, within quotation, QB, a comma, within quotation, tutorial, comma, within quotation, 3. I'll go ahead, run. And by using the commas, I get the output placed within columns. Let's try something similar with semicolons. Print, within quotation, QB, semicolon, within quotation, tutorial, semicolon, within quotation, 3. Go ahead, run. The strings are smashed together. So what I like to do is fix this by placing spaces before the ending quotation mark. Go ahead, run. Makes it a lot easier to read. And next, with a simple calculation, print. Calculation within quotations. Semicolon. And then a simple calculation, I'll have 4 plus 5. Run. And we find that there's a space between the string and the calculation. If I were to change this semicolon to a comma and run again, automatically everything is placed within columns. I'll change it back to a semicolon. Here's the program that we made within tutorial 2. And one of the problems of this type of program is that when I go ahead and run, we find the answers, but we don't see what the math was that made this answer. So I like to put in some text telling the user what is happening. So within quotation, I'm going to put in 5 plus 10 equal, and then a semicolon. I'm going to go ahead and run. Now we see what's going on. So I'm going to go ahead and do this for all the mathematics. Okay, I'll go ahead and run. And there's my program.